Hi, handsome soul. Here we go again. Joe O'Dowd has prepared a special, special show for you today. Sesame Street, number 220, in color.
I've been fixing a doorknob up the street. Doorknob broke on
it. Oh, look who's here. Hi, everybody.
Hi.
A doorknob?
Yeah.
When are you going to come finish the bookcase that you and Gordon started? Yeah, you remember my
bookcase? I forgot about it. I'm so sorry. Listen, I'll tell you what. How about I do it at the beginning of next week?
How about you come look at it now?
Okay.
Okay. Come on, Franny. You want to come too?
Okay.
Hi, Oscar.
Hi, Oscar.
Hi.
What's the matter with you? You
sound... it's nothing.
You seem so depressed. What's
wrong?
Matter?
Come on, you can tell us.
Well, it's just that, I can't tell you.
Oh, come on. You could, really? Are you going to tell us now or not?
Well, it's just that I wish that... You'll think I'm silly.
Oh, listen, Oscar, we won't think you're silly. We won't tell anybody. Come on.
You won't think I'm silly?
No.
No, whisper.
You can tell us.
Come on, right. Well, it's just that I wish I was an octopus.
that's not silly. An octopus? Why an octopus?
Well, because an octopus can make all kinds of music.
One for the fiddle. Two for the bow. Three for the trumpet. And four to blow. Five for the drum. Six for the stick, seven for the guitar, eight for the pick, nine for the piano, 10 for the hand, hooray for the octopus, one man band. One for the fiddle, two for the bow, three for the trumpet and four to blow, five for the drum, six for the stick, seven for the guitar, eight for the pick, nine for the piano, 10 for the hand. Hooray for the octopus one-man band.
See? An octopus can make all kinds of music.
Yeah, but Oscar...
Play all different kinds of musical instruments.
But Oscar, that's such a special octopus.
Sure is.
Well, I don't care. I like music sometimes. Rotten music. But I don't know how to play any musical instruments, and I don't even have any musical instruments.
You don't?
No. Oscar, you know what? I think I can fix that.
You can?
Yeah. Now, you got a lot of trash in there, right?
Well, it's my hobby.
Yeah. Do you have a broomstick handle? Like that?
I got a half a broomstick.
Oh, that's even better.
Half a broomstick? What are you going to do with half a broomstick?
Oh, great. That's perfect.
Yeah.
And I bet you got a lot of rags in there, huh?
Well, yeah, sure.
Well, let me have a rag. And you got any rubber bands?
Yeah, in my rubber band collection.
Oh, that's perfect. That's just the right side. Could you hold that?
Okay, I'll hold the rubber band.
What you going to make then?
I bet you don't know.
No, I don't know.
I don't know either.
Okay, you're going to be really surprised.
No, I'm going to be surprised.
All right.
A club?
No. Now we're going to take the rubber band. And we wrap it around like that. Mm-hmm. And you know what that is?
No.
What is it?
Guess.
It's a broken broomstick with a rag tied on with an elastic band.
No. Well, it's that,
it's
too.
It's a musical instrument?
No, it's a drumstick.
Oh, yeah? A drumstick.
Yeah.
Hey, it is sort of like a drumstick.
Sure.
Sure, you could use that.
There's only one thing.
What's that?
I don't have a drum.
Oh, yes, you do, Oscar. Now, come on, be a little creative. Look around. You've got something you can use for a drum.
Hey, my trash can lid.
Sure. Or the trunk over here.
Hey, let me see that. Okay. Let me give it a try.
Here you go.
Okay.
That's
it. Yeah.
Yeah, that's pretty good. I'm a drummer.
Very good. Come on, let's go. Come on, Oscar.
I got natural rhythm.
Yeah.
Hey, I'm a drummer.
Yeah.
I can make all kinds of rotten music. There's only one thing wrong.
What's that?
What?
I want to play in a band like the Octopus.
Oh.
A band.
Hmm.
So you need other instruments,
you know,
more people to play.
Right, and I got a great idea. You know what we're going to do? Susan and I are going to go around, and we're going to round up everybody, and we're going to make musical instruments out of things that we just find lying around.
We are?
And we'll make a band, and we'll play a song.
You know,
that sounds all right to me.
Okay,
yeah,
we'll do it.
Yeah, me too. I'll go get Bob, Miguel, and Gordon.
Okay.
Let's make some instruments. Hey,
Bob. Yeah.
See you later.
Gordon.
Okay.
I think he's in town.
This is an X. Even upside down, it's still an X. Many words begin with X, such as, X begins, did I show you when you... Yeah, I showed you that. All right. X is a very important letter. Many words end with X. Such as,
I came running around the kind of phone.
Pardon me? Fox. Box. Ox. Fix. Axe. Yeah. One more X I should mention. Exit. Goodbye.
Once again, it's time for Larry and Phyllis. Today we find Phyllis working on the invitations to the party.
Hi.
Hi, Larry.
You mailing invitations to our party?
Yes, I am. Certainly are a lot of them.
Boy, that looks like hard work.
It's not bad.
What do you have to do there? You have to fold the invitation and put it in the envelope, and then lick the envelope all the way closed, and then push it shut, and then take a stamp and lick it and put the stamp on the envelope and then rip the other stamps off. Boy, that looks like hard work to me.
Well, it's pretty hard, but I don't mind.
Hey, I have an idea. Why don't I help you do that? Why don't we, Coopengrobe?
Coopengrobe. Knuber, Kniber.
Knibber-robber.
Knarsum. Corral.
Cooperate.
Parade.
Why don't we cooperate?
Cooperate, sure. Well, we could cooperate, but I thought you were going to go down to the store and get the decorations for the party. That was going to be your job.
Anybody can do that, Phyllis. But it would be better if I helped you do this hard work right
here.
Well,
if you want to cooperate, I tell you what.
Yeah?
I will fold the invitations and put them in the envelope.
Yep.
Then you lick the envelope and seal it shut and put the stamps on, okay?
All right. Here we go.
Here we go. Here's your stamps.
Okay.
Okay, ready? Go.
Okay.
Fold my invitation, put it in the envelope, and give it to you. One. Fold my invitation, put it in the envelope, give it to you. Two, fold my invitation, put it in the envelope, and give it to you. Three, fold my invitation, put it in the envelope,
Phyllis,
give it to you. Four,
Phyllis,
and fold my
Phyllis,
invitation.
Phyllis, you're going too fast.
Oh.
Going fast is not good cooperation.
I'm sorry.
My tongue can't go as fast as that, so...
I'm sorry, Larry.
We better just slow down.
I'll do it much more slowly.
Okay.
Okay?
That's good cooperation.
Right, okay. Fold my invitation, put it in my envelope, and I give it to you.
Phyllis, whistling isn't good cooperation either. That's not very good cooperation when you're sitting and whistling on me while I'm trying to put a stamp on an envelope.
Larry, I'm sorry. I was just whistling while I was waiting for you to catch up with me.
Yeah, well, I'll do a lot of things, but don't whistle on me.
I'm sorry. No more whistling.
No, that's not good cooperation.
Right, I'm sorry.
Okay, here we go.
I got my invitation, fold it, put it in the envelope, give it to you.
Phyllis! Don't do dusting on me, because that's the worst cooperation of anything. When you're dusting on me and I'm trying to put a stamp on an envelope. So what we're going to do is... What are we going to do? I have a terrific idea.
What's that?
What we're going to do is I'm going to put the invitations in the envelope, and then you're going to close them and take the stamp and lick the stamp and put the stamp on the envelope.
Okay, that's a good idea.
That's better cooperation.
All right, Larry.
Okay.
Okay.
Here we go.
How's it going?
Oh, I have a terrific idea. I know what we'll do.
What's that, Larry?
You're going to take the envelope and put the invitation in it
right,
and close it up and lick it closed and take the stamp and lick the stamp and put the stamp on the envelope, and I'm going to go out and get the decorations.
Oh, great.
You're going to make an instrument out of this conglomeration stuff?
We sure are. We're going to make a little kind of flute.
We are?
Let's take this. Well, this is about long enough. This is a vise, boys and girls. See, I put that in there like that, and I squeeze it like that, and that holds it real tight. Then we're going to mark down here about, let's say about 2 inches. And we're going to take this kind of a saw. Anybody know what that saw is?
Hacksaw.
That's right. This cuts metal. And we're going to cut in here just a little bit.
Want us to hold the table?
Yeah.
Okay.
We're going to cut just a little bit through and make like a whistle.
Mm-hmm.
Cut a little bit that way.
Like,
and then we're going to cut on a slant. That.
Cuts right through that metal.
Yeah, that's a good saw.
Pretty sharp.
See that?
Yeah, sharp edges.
Now, you want to get rid of all those sharp edges. Anybody know what this is? Robin, what's that? That's a file. Right. And this is a metal file. We're going to file this down, make it nice and smooth on the outside. And I have a special little file, a little round file, to make it smooth on the inside. Like that. Now, we're ready to make the other piece the mouthpiece. We're going to take this old broomstick here, and we'll put it in the vise.
Make a musical instrument out of a broomstick, huh?
And a piece of pipe.
That's
and we're
going to
cut a 2-inch piece off of that. And what kind of a saw are we going to use?
Wood saw.
That's right. Could you hold that, please, Danny?
Move your fingers, Danny.
Oh, he's doing fine.
Good.
Wow, I saw that. All right. Now, who'd believe we'd be able to make a whistle out of this? Excuse
me.
All right. Put it back in the vise. And what is this?
That's a plane. I know that.
Right. We're going to take this round thing and make a flat place on the top.
Well, that's where you get those curly cues.
Yes, yeah, so you're going to take cute, Robin?
Good.
Do a little bit more. And I think we'll probably have a nice whistle. And we're going to try to
make it flat like that on top?
Well, that's so we can blow the air through that that little slot right down there. Do you see that?
Mm-hmm.
Doesn't quite fit. I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to put a piece of tape around it. And that'll make it fit perfectly. Like that. See?
Mm-hmm.
Let's stick it in there. And if we got any luck at all, we're going to have a whistle.
Mm-hmm.
Almost got it. Let's push that back a little bit. How's that sound?
Good.
Now, does anybody have a pitch pipe?
Yeah, I brought my pitch pipe out.
Let's see. Play a middle C on that.
Middle C.
Oh, we're way below that. Mm-hmm. Tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to cut off the end of this so we can tune it right to that note, okay?
Oh, you make it shorter to make it higher.
Right. Now, let's everybody remember this note. Mm-hmm. Okay, everybody got that note?
While you saw.
Yeah, so we can see how much it changes.
Okay.
All right, here we go. All right. Okay, everybody stop now. Now listen to this. See how that's higher?
Yeah.
Now play the C again. We're still not there yet. We have to do some more cutting.
Today's secret drawing will be a mailman.
Put a hat on him.
Like a policeman.
Like a policeman's hat.
Yeah. Now make a suit.
Now make
a suit.
Make a
suit.
Put buttons.
Put four buttons.
Four.
Four buttons.
Make a bag with letters in.
I guess he's a fireman.
No!
Do firemen carry letters?
A mail lady?
No!
Do you know a mail lady carries letters?
Old man ran.
Oh, gosh.
That's
hey,
it. We got it.
Okay, you got a C.
Okay. Now, you see what I did here? I put two pieces of tape on the side of the whistle.
Mm-hmm.
The reason I did that, because too much air comes through, we get a better note that way.
Oh, good.
And then on the end, I cut it off at the slant so it fits into my mouth better so I can blow.
And you really file it all down so it's nice and smooth so you don't hurt yourself,
yes,
right?
Yes, ma'am.
That's good.
Okay, now we don't want to play just one note. We want to be able to play a song. So what we're going to do, put it back in the vise, and we're going to drill some holes along here and see if we can make notes,
mm-hmm.
Okay?
Okay. How do you know where to put the note?
Well, to tell you the truth, we kind of have to guess.
Oh, okay, that makes
fun. Let's see, that's about 2 inches up there. This is a center punch to make a little hole so I can start the drill. Put one there, and one about an inch away, right there, and maybe another one there. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Now, what's this big thing?
The drill.
That's right.
You need us to hold the table somewhere?
Yes, please. Okay, here we go.
Yeah, okay. Back up.
But it's fast, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Well, that had to be on a slant, and you can't cut a slant with that.
Why would it make that much difference?
Well, you see, if it's a slanted hole, then the air comes out and makes that whistling sound.
Oh.
Now, let's see. Who, do you think we have any notes? We do.
Guess we have.
That's great. Okay, let's drill some more holes, and maybe we can get like a piano, make it sound like that. Have a lot of notes. All right.
Hi, Susan. Hi, John.
Hi.
What are you doing? What are you making there?
We're making a recorder.
Do you want to hear it? Yes.
Okay.
Play some notes.
I heard that music.
Yeah, he just made that out of a pipe and a broomstick. Isn't that something?
Oh, yeah.
That's a great instrument because it doesn't cost any
money. We're trying to make some notes now.
Hey, that's great.
Isn't that great? Okay, I'm going to make some more notes. I think we ought to have about eight. How about
I was
eight?
Going to say six or eight.
Okay. We'll make some more holes.
Well, here I am in my tubby again, and my tubby's all filled with water and nice fluffy suds. And I've got my soap and washcloth to wash myself, and I've got my nifty scrub brush to help me scrub my back, and I've got a big fluffy towel to dry myself when I'm done. But there's one other thing that makes tubby time the very best time of the whole day. And do you know what that is? It's a very special friend of mine. My very favorite little pal. Oh, rubber ducky, you're the one. You make bath time lots of fun. Rubber ducky, I'm awfully fond of you. Bo, bo, bo-dee-o, rubber ducky, joy of joys. When I squeeze you, you make noise. Rubber ducky, you're my very best friend, it's true. Oh, every day when I make my way to the tubby, I find a little fella who's cute and yellow and chubby. Rub-a-dub-dubby, rubber ducky, you're so fine, and I'm lucky that you're mine. Rubber ducky, I'm awfully fond of you. Hey, rubber ducky, would you like me to scrub your back with my nifty little scrub brush? You would? Okay, how's this? Hey, you want me to scrub behind your ears? Ooh, I see. You don't have any ears, do you? Well, how about your tummy? Scrub his little ducky tummy. Ooh, he's ticklish. Ooh. Oh, every day when I make my way through the tubby, I find a little fella who's cute and yellow and chubby. Rub-a-dub-dubby, rubber ducky, you're so fine, and I'm lucky that you're mine. Rubber ducky, I'm like a whole pond of rubber ducky, I'm awfully fond of you.
Boy, Gordon, you must be awful thirsty.
Yeah, I am. Got a lot of water here.
Golly. Maybe you could do this with lemonade.
With lemonade?
Sure.
Oh, I never did with lemonade. Mm. Now, I'm about ready to assemble everybody.
He's got a lot of glasses there.
Group?
Oscar.
Group?
Hey,
come
group.
Come forward.
Here, what do you got to show?
Look what Gordon's doing.
He's going to serve refreshments, I think.
Back up, Athelstan.
What is that, Gordon?
It's a magical, mystical, musical method that I picked
what?
Up on a
What's
tour
that?
Into the far water glass country. Where what we did when we wanted.
For what?
For making music. This makes
with
me.
With glasses?
With glasses, of course.
Yeah, glasses and water make music?
Do glasses and water make music?
Yeah, you just asked that. Do it?
Do it? Well, I'll show you. This is a note. Because that's a note. And that's a note. And that is. And this is.
That's amazing.
Hey.
But they're all different sizes.
Oh, very clever, Franny. You know why? Because if you put a lot of water in a glass like this, see, it makes the note higher than that one, which has less water. This has even less water. Guess what? Every time, and you see down here, the glasses are actually smaller.
Gee, yeah.
See? Notice that?
Can you use the same size glasses?
Yeah. And
what else did you notice about the glasses?
They look very much like my glasses.
They do, but I really got them out of Mr. Hooper's store.
You sure?
Same brand of glasses that I bought for you last Christmas.
I think we should see if it's in tune.
Want to see if it's in tune?
Yeah.
I'll give you a C.
That's it.
See? I've been pouring water for a long time.
Does it matter that the glasses are a different size?
No.
Well, yes, it does, yeah. These down here are smaller glasses, you see. Now, I'm going to give you a little rendition of the ABC song.
Oh, boy.
We hope. Watch. Oh, no. Let's start over again.
A-F-G. H-I-J-K-L-M-N-O-P U-R-S-T-U-V W-X-Y-N-Z Learn my ABCs. Next time won't you sing with me?
Nothing to it.
Hey, Gordon!
Yes?
Play Melancholy Baby.
I will. I will. One of these days, Oscar, at your request, I'll play Melancholy Baby.
How about
and a couple
row
others that
boat?
You've never heard before, huh?
Row,
oh, no,
row
no.
Your boat?
Look, wait a minute. Just play the alphabet song, right?
Yeah.
Now, I'm going to show you another version of the alphabet song, and here it is.
Are you ready, Gloria?
Yes, ma'am.
All right, step back while I give you a standard introduction.
All right.
Now, here's Gloria to entertain us with her rendition of the fantastic and lilting alphabet song. Gloria?
A, B, C, D, E, F, G.
Gorgeous.
H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P.
Hold it, not so fast. That's it.
Sorry, ma'am. Q, R, S, T, U, V.
Perfectamente.
W, and X, Y, Z.
Not to speak of groovy.
Now I know my ABCs. Won't you come and play with me? There, how was that?
Fine, but would you mind taking it again from the beginning?
Yes, I would.
I don't blame you. Good day.
Roger.
The name's Hortense.
Sorry, sir. Rum.
Hey, want to ride in my bus? That's not a real bus.
Sure it is. Come on, get in.
That'll be 25 cents, please. You're not a real bus driver.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not. I know because my dad's a real bus driver.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, sometimes I ride with him all day long.
Really? All day?
Well, not all day, because he gets up too early.
I bet he hates to get up that early.
Oh, he doesn't mind it. He has a lot to do before he drives his bus. He has to test everything to make sure it's safe.
Gee, nobody rides a bus that early in the morning.
Sure they do.
Well, good morning.
Good morning.
First customer of the day.
My dad says the best part is meeting all the people. You get to meet almost everybody in the city.
Tomorrow.
get it. It lets them see people run for the bus. I like to ride the bus with my dad.
Boy, I should like to drive a bus like that.
I thought you were a bus driver already.
Oh, yeah. Give me 25 cents or you'll have to get off the bus.
Hey, Franny, you've been learning about all different kinds of musical instruments today, haven't you?
Oh, yeah, I sure have.
The glasses that Gordon had, right?
Right.
And the recorder.
Oh, yeah, that was neat. He made that out of a pipe.
Yeah, and an old broomstick.
Right.
Do you know how to make a kazoo?
A kazoo?
Mm.
No, I know what it is. It's another instrument.
That's right.
How can you make one?
Well, you can make one very simply out of a comb.
A comb?
Any kind of a comb. It can be big or little.
Gee.
And a piece of tissue paper.
Oh, I've got that at home. My
sure.
mommy has that.
Kind you wrap up presents in, right?
Yeah.
And all you have to do, you see, if I blow or hum through this comb without the tissue paper, nothing happens. It goes,
mm-hmm.
mm, nothing. Just like, mm, as though I didn't have a comb.
Right.
But if I lay the tissue paper...
And now you blow on it?
No, you don't blow on it. You have to hum through it. Because
oh.
if I blow, nothing happens.
I see.
But if I hum, it makes the tissue paper sort of vibrate. That means go back and forth against the comb, right? And then it sounds like this. So I can make play a little song.
Gee, that's really neat. Can I try that?
Sure.
Can I hum on it?
Sure.
Okay, now I take a deep breath.
Mm-hmm. Take a deep breath and don't blow, but hum on it.
Okay.
Okay, ready? Hey, that's terrific.
Boy, that was great fun.
You're a professional kazoo player.
Oh, thanks, gee. That was nice.
Let's see, I'm going to make an X on this blackboard here. That is, I'm going to try to make an X. I'm not really sure I remember what an X looks like. Maybe an X looks like this. No. That's not an X. That's nothing but a 2. I'll get rid of that. Let's see, maybe an X looks like this. Is that an X? No, that's not an X. That's nothing but a dumb 3. Huh. Get rid of that one. I guess I really give up on it. I'll wait till old Bert comes along. He'll tell me how to make an X. But meanwhile, I'll play myself a game of tic-tac-toe. And then we go tic-tac-toe. Ha! I win! But I still don't know what an X looks like.
Hey, Ernie.
Hey, Bert. Hey, listen, Bert.
Hey, Ernie.
Yes?
Hey, I see you're doing pretty good with your X's there.
My what?
Yeah, your X's on the board. Hey, let's count them, okay? Yeah, okay. There's one X.
You mean that thing with the that and the that? That's
yeah,
an X?
Yeah, that's right. That's an X. Somebody... Let's count them now. One X,
one,
two X's,
one,
three X's,
huh?
Four X's,
huh?
Five X's down in the corner. Hey, that's great, Ernie. You've been studying. Okay, keep up the good work. See you later.
Oh, wow. Look at that. I made an X. I made five X's. I knew what an X was all along, and I didn't even know that I knew it. Gee whiz, I'm going to go out and make myself an X that I can carry with me wherever I go. Boy, am I happy. Wow, hoo-hoo.
This is an X. Even upside down, it's still an X. Many words begin with X, such as, well, of course, we... X begins... Did I show you when you... Yeah, I showed you that. All right. X is a very important letter. Many words end with X. Such as, how you...
I came running around a crazy fool.
Pardon me? Oh, yeah. Fox. Box. Ox. Fix. Axe. Yeah. One more X I should mention. Exit. Goodbye.
Well, here it is. My very own ex. You know, ex, without an ex, you couldn't make a word like, well, you couldn't make box, or you couldn't make x-ray. My very own ex.
Hey, Ernie, Ernie, it's terrible. It's just awful what just happened to me.
Well, what's the matter, Bert?
Oh, see, I was in the kitchen, making some bacon.
Yeah?
You know, and this monster appeared, this huge monster appeared. And he ate all my bacon. Every strip of my bacon he ate. Oh, that's awful.
Well, that's terrible, Bert. Yeah. I mean, we can't just sit still while a monster comes and eats all your bacon.
No.
I mean, what are we going to do about it? I mean, is it... Hey, no. What are you doing, monster? Oh, my very own ex. Why do you do that, monster?
I always like to eat bacon and eggs.
Stupid monster.
X-ray. X.
Hey, come here. See what I'm making here. I'm making a musical instrument. You know how all this musical instrument is called? This is what you call maracas. Maracas. And it's very easy to make. See, you got a container like this. It's like a coffee container? Like a coffee container. Mm. You can use any container you want, as long as you have a lid. You know, to cover it up. And, but you can use rice like this, you know. Mm-hmm. It's easy to get home. You get rice home. And you put it inside a container. And then you cover, you put the lid on. And just shake it. See?
Hey.
See? I'll make another one.
What's this?
Huh? That's gravel. You can use anything. Any kind of seed. Gravel, or you can use... or seeds, any kind, or rice, or anything.
Rice?
Yeah. Now, here's another one. Okay? You take this one. And here, you take another one.
I got one.
Take one. You got one? You got yours. Right here. You got another here. Here, Bob.
Can I take one?
Oh, you want to play that?
Yeah, I'll play my card.
Okay, I'll play with two of them.
Okay, everybody, it's time for our word song.
Right, and today we got an I and a G over here. That spells ig.
So we're going to sing a song all full of ig words. Are you ready?
Oh, I sure am.
Well, let's go.
Okay. I'll start it off here, all right?
All righty.
Here we go.
You take a B, that's a B, and an I, G, ig. You put them both together and they spell big.
That's big, B-I-G, big.
That's big, B-I-G, big.
You take a B, that's a B,
and an I, G, ig. You put them all together and they spell big.
Yeah, we did that all right, didn't we?
Sure did.
Okay, sure did. Here we go.
You take a D, that's a D, and an I, G, ig. You put them all together and they spell dig.
That's dig, D-I-G, dig.
That's dig, D-I-G, dig.
You take a D, that's a D,
and an I, G, ig. You put them all together and they spell dig. Oh, boy, that's so much fun. Now, go right ahead now.
You take a P, that's a P,
and an I, G, ig. You put them all together and they spell pig.
That's pig, P-I-G, pig.
That's pig, P-I-G, pig.
You take a P, that's a P,
and an I, G, ig. You put them all together and they spell pig.
Oink, oink there.
All righty, just fell right on.
You take a W, woo,
and an I-G-ig. You put them all together and they spell wig.
That's wig, W-I-G, wig.
That's wig, W-I-G, wig.
You take a W, woo,
and an I-G-ig. You put them all together and they spell wig. Ig.
Yeah, we did that, all right?
Ernie, get in here.
Oh, hi there, Bert.
Yeah.
How are you?
Yeah, hi, how are you? Don't give me that. I'm mad, and I think you know why.
Oh, well, no, Bert, I don't know. Why are you mad?
Now, what does the word cookie mean to you, Ernie?
Cookie. Oh, cookie is my very favorite word of all. And it means it's my very favorite dessert of all. Uh-huh. And it means a great big plate of cookies just like these right here. That's what cookie
those
means.
Right there. Mm-hmm. Well, now put that down. Those are my cookies now, Ernie.
Oh, no, Bert. No. These right here are my cookies. You see, your cookies were out here on this plate right here.
Uh-huh. I know they were out here, Ernie, and I think you know what happened to them. I mean, there are clues, Ernie, and if we examine the clues, we can figure out what happened to my cookies.
Well sure, Bert, but what sort of clues?
Well, clue number one. The cookies were here on this plate, but now, Ernie, now they're not here anymore. Just some old crumbs.
Yes, that's...
And you're eating the crumbs, huh?
That's true, but...
Sure, why not?
But what else, Bert?
Well, okay, now clue number two. If you were me, and you happened to see a fella just about the size of, you, Ernie, with a tuft of black hair on top of his head, in a red and blue striped shirt, come in and take the cookies off the plate, what would you think?
Well, I guess I would think that... Maybe old Ernie had come in and taken your cookies, Bert.
Right.
But I didn't.
And then if the guy who did that went... just like that, yeah. What would you think, huh?
Well, I guess I'd really think that old Ernie had come out and taken your cookies, Bert. But you see, I didn't take your cookies, Bert.
Oh, yeah? Oh, yeah? Mm. Well, what about those three clues, huh? What about them?
Well, I don't know.
What?
Cookie. Hi, Bert.
Hey, John, what do you got going for you now here?
We're going to make a washtub base.
A washtub base?
Yeah. I just drill a hole through there and through here.
Right.
Now, I'm going to put this ring like this through the top like that. And we're going to take a nut and a washer and attach it from the other side.
Keep it from slipping out.
Right.
This is a washtub base, huh?
You're getting pretty good on that.
Yeah.
I'm just going to screw it up on this side so it's nice and tight.
Right.
Has anybody got a piece of string?
Yeah.
Oh, that's great.
Hey.
Looks like it might be just about right. All right, we're going to tie it down here, like that. And then we're going to take it.
You sure you know what you're doing here, huh?
I think I do. Let's stick it through the top here, if we can, and tie it up here, too. You're not going to believe how great this sounds. Okay, is everybody ready?
Yes.
I want everybody to count the notes, okay? Okay, ready? Let's count. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, 10, 11, 12, 13. How about that?
Hey, that's terrific. That
Let's try and play
good.
Can you play the drum? We'll play a little song here.
All right.
One, two, three, four. Thank you.
What's new?
Nothing.
Huh? Hey, no. That's not true. You know, you've been down at the zoo all day now. Something must have happened there. Something happens there every day.
No. Huh? No. Nothing happened there today. No? Nothing. Not today.
Huh.
Oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute. I got a teeny-weeny scrape on my finger here. Teeny-weeny scrape, see?
Well, there. Now, you see, something did happen. Mm. Now, Ernie, tell me. How did you get that scrape there?
Yeah, I must have gotten it when I fell down.
Oh?
Yeah, I think that was it.
Well, how'd you fall down?
Well, let's see. That must have happened when I was running away from the dog.
Yep. Oh, the dog?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, why was the dog chasing you?
Well, he wasn't chasing me. See, I thought he was, but he was just running away from the tiger.
Oh. The tiger? Well, what was the tiger running around loose for?
Well, the monkey opened his cage by mistake.
The monkey? Oh, how did the monkey get loose, for heaven's sake?
Well, that's easy. See, he got out when I was trying to put the rabbit in his cage.
Now, hold it. Now, wait a minute. Now, wait. Why were you trying to put a rabbit in the monkey's cage?
Well, with all the elephants running around loose, I didn't want him to get stepped on.
The elephants? Sure. What were elephants doing loose?
Well, the hippopotamus was loose. Why not the elephants?
The hippopotamus? Now, all right, Ernie. All right. Now, how did the hippopotamuses get loose?
Well, I didn't see it. But I think it must have happened when the bus crashed into his cage.
The bus crashed? How did that happen?
The bus driver couldn't see because of the bright lights.
The bright lights?
From the flying saucer.
The flying saucer! Now look, you were saying a minute ago that nothing happened to you today.
Well, I was wrong, Bert.
I should hope so.
Yeah, I got a teeny-weeny scrape on this finger. See?
X-ray.
For making music?
Yeah. We're gonna make music out of all this stuff.
Well, you don't think we can do it?
No, what makes music anyway?
Yeah. Oh, you can make music out of anything.
Well, you can bang on it.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, you can make music out of anything.
You can bang on this kind of stuff, right?
Oh, yeah. It's plenty of fun. What are you talking about, Bob?
All right.
What makes music? Anything makes music. When you're happy on the inside, everything you hear is music.
An old tin can, that's music.
Yeah, that's music, right.
A frying pan, that's music.
An electric fan, that's music.
A paper and a comb, washboard and a bone.
A bucket that you bang on or a ringing telephone.
Hello?
What makes music? Anything makes music. When your heart is open wide, then everything around is music. And music fills the day like nothing else on earth can do. When I'm making music with you.
Hey, that's pretty good, huh?
Good.
Music, anything makes music. When you're happy on the inside, well, everything you hear is music.
A chocolate drink, that's music.
Of course it is.
A string you blink. That's music.
The kitchen sink. That's music.
How about this? A towel at your clock.
A washer at your pump.
Everybody clanking on a can of Rusty Jump.
What makes music? Anything makes music. When your heart is open wide, then everything around is music.
And music fills a day like nothing else on earth can do. When I'm making music with you.
What makes music? Anything makes music. When your heart is open wide, then everything around is music.
One for the fiddle, two for the bow, three for the trumpet, and four to blow. Five for the drum, six for the stick, seven for the guitar, eight for the pick, nine for the piano, 10 for the hand. Hooray for the octopus, one man band. One for the fiddle, two for the bow, three for the trumpet and four to blow. Five for the drum, six for the stick, seven for the guitar, eight for the pick, nine for the piano, 10 for the hand. Hooray for the octopus, one man band.
Four, four and four are eight, eight and eight are 16, 16 and 16 are 32,
two and two are four, four and four are eight, eight and eight are 16, 16 and 16 are 32.
Inchworm, inchworm, measuring the marigolds, you and your arithmetic, you'll probably go far. Inchworm, inchworm, measuring the marigolds, seems to me you'd stop and see how beautiful. Thank you.
personality and tea, you fill the air with smiles for miles and miles and miles. Though you're no Mona Lisa, for worlds I'd not replace your sunny, funny face. Funny face. Funny face. You're not exotic, but so hypnotic. You're much too much. If you can cook the way you look, I'd swim the ocean wide just to have you by my side. Oh, you're no Queen of Sheba, for worlds I'd not replace your sunny, funny face.
Well, you know what? You know what we have to do? We have to say goodbye. You want to say goodbye? Everybody? Bye! Bye! Bye!
Bye! Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letter X and by the number 13, and I still wish I was an octopus. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.
This is PBS, the Public Broadcasting Service.